What is going on, my friends? Today, we have a commentary. We have a video, but the video is not important. The commentary is important. And it's relevant because, well, most of us, West Coast is not getting any rain. But everyone else is getting drowned. The Midwest is getting hit with a lot of rain. East Coast is even getting it as well. Everyone is getting a lot of water. So it's relevant to us because it's something I wanted to talk about, a storm story. You know, storm story. Some of us have these, some of us don't. But I tweeted out earlier, any Midwest or Tornado Alley residents ever seen a tornado? Because a lot of people have never seen a tornado in real life, which is kind of weird. For us in the Midwest, we see them all the time. Well, I guess we didn't see them all the time, but we've seen them, you know. They're around. You live in the Midwest for many years, you're eventually going to see a tornado. Because you don't want to, really, because it's not safe or good. But you see them. And I have seen one, and I actually had a house that was hit by just the outer edges of one, and thankfully didn't receive too much damage, and that's the story, pretty much. So in 1998, there was a really big storm that had gone through where I live, and it was at our rental house, a rental property. It wasn't our house. We were having our house built, and it was in the summer, which is prime time for tornadoes because that's just, it seems they don't ever want to come. Okay, how it works. The tornado, the reason it's called Tornado Alley, it's like 6 or 7 states that make up Tornado Alley in the Midwest. It's because the high pressure and low pressure that meet up from the north and south meet up, and they collide. One's forced down, one's forced up. They begin to spin. That's what forms tornadoes, is the spinning clouds and things like that. Okay? And that's why it's in Tornado Alley. It's very common. It's hot, common in summer because you get the hot spells and the low pressure systems that move in from the north. That's why it happens. When it's cold in the Midwest and in the like later parts of the year, it's just cold and colder. Like it can't make a tornado from cold and colder. So it needs to be warm and cold. And that's what happens in summer. All right, enough of a lesson there. I don't know a lot about it. I just know kind of what I've learned from watching a lot of documentaries and things. Okay. To continue, 1998 summer. It's up a little cul-de-sac. Our house is like up a little like a driveway, and then there's two houses there, one on the left, one on the right. Ours is on the one on the left. It had a cherry tree. It was really cool. It had a pool. The one on the right was a really cool house as well. Those were our neighbors. They had kids in my grade. They had 3 kids. We had like myself, my brother, and sister. It was all like, you know, it worked out well. We were good families. We always had fun hanging out together, and we were doing that in the summer. All of us were hanging out. We're about outside. I think our parents were maybe inside making something, but all the kids were outside, and then you heard the tornado sirens go off, and you're like, holy shit. The tornado sirens, man. And if you don't hear those very often, a tornado sirens signify a tornado warning. A tornado warning means there's a tornado that's already touched down and it's on the ground, or it was on the ground. Now it's maybe receded, but another tornado can touch down very soon. Another tornado can come down very, very quickly after one. And it's supposed to mean get the hell inside and get in your basement. That's what you're taught to do, to like seek cover, get in your basement. Not really sure how that's supposed to protect you from that kind of shit, but it's what you're taught, okay? So the tornado warning goes off, and our parents come outside, like, everyone get inside really quick, everyone get in. So our neighbors go in their home, we go in our home, we go down to our basement, which is like it's like 25% done. It's all hard, like cement ground and cold, so we had a blanket down there we were sitting on. It was myself, my brother was really young, I was only 8, my sister was basically a baby, she was only like 2, and my mom were down there. My dad was on a business trip at the time, he wasn't around. And then my mom, after like 10 or 15 minutes, she's like, shit, I forgot Coco, which was our first dog. So she had to go upstairs and go get Coco. And she goes up the stairs, and there's a door, and then you open the door, and Coco was at the door. But she basically grabbed the dog and flung Coco down the stairs. Like, and we didn't know why. She was freaking out. She came screaming, like running down the stairs. Like, she's like, everyone, like, grab onto something. Like, make sure, because what happened afterwards, she had told us this, was that she had gone up the stairs and opened the door to grab Coco. Coco was at the door. And she looked to her right and saw that, like, we had a window there to our right, maybe like 30 feet away from the door. There's a window, a big window, like maybe a 5-foot by 5-foot window. And it's the middle of it's like a family room window that looks out to the right of our property. I guess if you look to the left, if you're driving up to the driveway. But and there's 2 trees out there, and like the trees, she could barely see the trees, but they were like all the way bent over completely. There was a bunch of water, like it was like almost like you're driving on the interstate, driving into rain that was coming down really quick, but you're also driving into it like 60 or 70 miles an hour. Like you could not see out the window type of shit. So she was freaking out and screaming at us. And we had this radio down there. So sirens tell you to get into the basement, but there's no siren to tell you when you can come out.
But you have a radio. My dad had this old CB radio that was really obnoxious. I'll try to imitate it here. It's going to be annoying. I'm sorry. But it went like a noise like, this is a weather service warning. And it would tell you about the stuff that's going on. It's old school. People don't do it nowadays because they have cell phones. We still have the radio. But whenever I hear that radio now, man, that signifies, oh, shit, things are about to get real, you know? Because I always remember that when I was younger with bad weather and violent weather. So that's what I associate it with. Anyway, let's continue. She had flung the dog down the stairs. She ran down the stairs. She was like, we were all like basically huddled together in the basement, which wasn't going to do shit to a tornado. And it was a decent tornado that had gone through. It was an F3 at the time, I think, when we looked it up afterwards, of course. But what had happened was the tornado barely missed the home. Like, it was on the outskirts of the house. I guess the outskirts of the tornado were on the edge of our house. And it had ended up going west of us just a little bit. But when we finally were able to come upstairs, maybe like an hour and a half later, I'm in the basement. Like, this storm went on for a long... Actually, well, we were able to go up like 45 minutes later. And then after 10 minutes of being upstairs, we had saw some of the damage of like all the trees and everything around the property. We had to go back downstairs again because the sirens went off again. So after like an hour and a half to 2 hours of being in the basement waiting and listening to this radio go off, we're able to go upstairs and look around and like look outside and actually see what had happened. There were like a billion branches and leaves strewn around the yard. And we were able to go and count the trees. We had a lot of trees around the property. So many were gone or down. We counted 16 trees that were down. And we ended up finding one of the trees was uprooted and taken away. It was like a pine tree, a small pine tree. We found it a mile south of our home back in this property in like this field. It was insane. Like, how much force that shit has is crazy. But put your stories. I want to hear your guys' storm stories, if you could, in the comment section. I'm really interested in learning about these, and I read about them and watch them all the time. I want to hear your story. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will talk to you all later.